For more practice, we will see the example depends upon the partial fraction. In last lecture, we already studied the one example depends upon the partial fraction. Before starting this lecture, I will explain the about the rules of partial fraction. Rule number first. We already studied in lecture number first. I will again explain in within 2 minutes. So, if rule number first, P of x polynomial ax plus b cx plus d, this can be written as a divided by ax plus b, b divided by cx plus d. In last lecture, we have already studied example number first. We'll start the example number second. That is, x plus 4, x plus 4, x into x plus 1. So don't think about this x plus 4. So this is a, think about this. Our main target is that to separate this x and x plus 1. For this, firstly, write this expression in the form of, by using the rules of partial fraction, a divided by x. Here x plus 0, that is b divided by x plus 1. After that, our target is that separating this x and x plus 1 to find the value of this a and b. To find in the a and b, firstly, to multiply x, x plus 1 on the both sides. Then you will get x plus 4. So multiply by x, x plus 1 to both these sides or this whole equation. Then here you will get x plus 4 and multiplied by x into x plus 1. That x, x into x plus 1 will cancel. What will get? X plus 4. So, a into, also multiply x, x plus 1 to this a. Then you will get this x and x will cancel. What is the remaining? X plus 1. Plus b into, also multiply by b, x, x plus 1. Then you will get this x plus 1 and this x plus 1 will cancel. You will get b into x. After simplifying this equation, after simplifying this x, x plus 1, you will get x plus 4 is equal to a into x plus 1, b into x. Now, we will find the value of this a and b. To find the a and b, first of all, put the coefficient of this a is equal to 0. You will get the value of b. After put the coefficient of b equal to 0, you will get the value of a. So firstly, put x plus 1 is equal to 0, then you will get the x is equal to 1. First of all, call this equation number 1. This call as equation number 2. So coefficient of a is here x plus 1. X plus 1 equal to 0, which implies x is equal to minus 1, put in this equation number 2, then you will get the value of b because you are putting the coefficient of a. So x is equal to minus 1 in this equation. So minus 1 plus 4, that is plus 3. Minus 1 plus 1, so a into 0. So b, put the value of x is equal to minus 1. So 3 is equal to a into 0, 0. B into minus 1, that is minus 1. Hence, b is equal to minus 3. B is equal to minus 3. After putting the coefficient of a is equal to 0, after will that you will get find value of b. Next, put the value of coefficient of b equal to 0, that is x is equal to 0. Coefficient of b is x, that is equal to 0. Put in equation number 2. So 0 plus 4 is the 4. Next, a into 0 plus 1 and b into 0. So 4 is equal to a into 1. So a is equal to 1 by 4. Value of b is minus 3 and value of a is 1 by 4. The value of a and b put in equation number 1. This is equation number 1. Equation number 1 is x plus 4 divided by x plus 1. This is the main problem. After using the partial fraction, this problem can be expressed as in that way, a by x plus b by x plus 1 by rules of partial fraction. After finding the value of a and b, put here value of a is 1 by 4, value of b is minus 3. So equation number 1 can be converted into, so equation number 1 I will write once more. Here x plus 3, x plus 1, a divided by x, b divided by x plus 1. The value of a is 1 by 4, this whole divided by x, value of b is minus 3 divided by x plus 1. So this is the question, x plus 4, x into x plus 4. So these two terms can be separated by using the partial fraction. So this is example number second. We will see the example number third on rule number first, but some different type. Example number third, that is x minus 1 divided by 3x minus 5 x minus 3. First of all, check here. The power of x is 1. Means this is a simple monic polynomial. Here, power of x is also 1. Means this is also simple polynomial or term. So this is a first term, second term. Degree of this polynomial or term is 1. Degree of this polynomial and term is also 1. So by using the rules of partial fraction, this can be written as a divided by 3x minus 5 plus b divided by x minus 3. So this is the last example on rule number first. Then we will see the rule number second. It means what? It will clear after taking the 2 to 3 examples. So this is a method to expressing the in the form of partial fraction. So our main target is that after separating them, find the value of this a and b. For finding the a and b, multiply this 3x minus 5 and x minus 3 to this whole equation. This is equation number first. So multiply 3x minus 5 and x minus 3 to this equation, then you will get x minus 3 multiply 3x minus 5 and x minus 3 to a, then a into multiplied by 3x minus 5 and this 3x minus 5 will cancel, you will get here x minus 3. So b into multiplied by 3x multiply by b 3x minus 5 x minus 3, then x minus 3 x minus 3 will cancel, and what is the remaining? 3x minus 5. After that, put the coefficient of a equal to 0, will get the value of b, and put the coefficient of b equal to 0, you will get the value of a. So put x minus 3, this is a coefficient of a, equal to 0, which implies x is equal to 3, plus 3 minus 1, that is 2, a into 0, b into 3 into 3, 9, 9 minus 5 is the 4, so 2 is equal to 4b, so b is equal to 1 by 2. Next, after putting the coefficient of a equal to 0, we'll put coefficient of b is equal to 0. Coefficient of b is 3x minus 5 is equal to 0, which implies that 3x is equal to 5, which implies that x is equal to 3 by 5. Put this value in equation number, this called equation number 2. Put this value in equation number 2. Then what will you get? 3 by 5 minus 1. Here a into 3 by 5 minus 3, and here coefficient of b is 0. So its calculation is that 3 by 5 minus 1 is 5 minus cross multiplication 3 minus 5, 3 minus 5 divided by 5. That is minus 2 by 5. Here 3 by 5 minus 3, that is 3 cross multiplication 3 minus 15 divided by 5. So you will get here minus 12 by 5a. So this 5 5 cancel, minus minus cancel. So value of a is 6a is equal to 1, which implies that a is equal to 1 by 6. This is value of a is 1 by 6 and value of b is 1 by 2. After finding the value of a and b, put in equation number first. So this is equation number first. So I'll write once more for equation number 1. That is x minus 1 divided by 3x minus 5 is x minus 3. Value of a is 1 by 6 divided by 3x minus 5, and value of b is 1 by 2 divided by x minus 3. So this is example number third. One more example is remaining. If these two terms, after completion of this example, I will explain about the next. If these terms are in multiply, then you can find in that way. If instead of this, there is some polynomial, then how to find its partial fraction, that we will see in example number fourth. Example number 4. Suppose equation of the form x divided by 1 divided by x square plus 3x plus 2. Instead of that x, 1 divided by x square plus 3x plus 2. There is no any terms. There is only one equation. That is x square plus 3x plus 2 in the form of polynomial. So we'll see it's a solution. So this 1 divided by x square plus 3x plus 2 can be written as 1 divided by, find its root. So its root is that, using the quadratic equation, use this for finding the root, use this equation. We know that ax plus bx plus c is equal to 0. Then its root can be calculated by minus b plus minus b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. Or use a number in such a way that its addition is 2 and its multiplication is 3. That number is the x plus 1 and here x plus 2. This is a parts are, this is the roots of the x square plus 3x plus 2. So after separating this x plus 1 and x plus 2, we will do the simple calculation for this by using the partial fraction of the rule number first. It is 1 upon x plus 1 divided by x plus 2. So see here, power of this x is 1, whole power of this bracket is also 1. Power of this x is 1 and whole power of this bracket is also 1. So because of that, this can be expressed in the form of any arbitrary constant a, or you can take any k1, k2, divided by first term x plus 1. Secondly, b divided by x plus 2. After that, expressing in the form, we will find the value of this a and b. For this, we will multiply to this whole equation. Firstly, we will call this is equation number 1. This call as equation number 2. After this expression, we will find the value of a and b. To find the value of a and b, we will multiply this equation number 2 by x plus 1 and x plus 2. Then you will get 1 into multiply by a 2, x plus 1 and x plus 2. Then x plus 1 and x plus 1 will cancel. You will get x plus 2. So b into multiply by this x plus 2 and this x plus 2 will cancel. Then x plus 1. So firstly, put the coefficient of a equal to 0, we will get the value of b. After that, put the coefficient of b equal to 0, you will get the value of a. So put x plus 2 is equal to 0, that is x is equal to minus 2 in this equation. So 1 into minus 2 plus 2, 0. So a into 0, b into minus 2 plus 1, that is minus 1. Hence, 1 is equal to b into minus 1. So b is equal to minus 1. After that, put x plus 1 is equal to 0. So x is equal to minus 1 in this equation. So 1 into minus 1 plus 2. So a into 1, b into 0. So a is equal to minus 1. So value of a is 1 and value of b is minus 1. So put the value of this a and b in equation number 2. So equation number 2 you will get, that is 1 divided by x plus 1, x plus 2. So value of a is 1 divided by x plus 1 and value of b is the minus 1 divided by x plus 2. So this is the example number 4. After that, last example, if there are 3 terms, then how to find the its solution? We will see that. And after that, we will see about the rule number 7. Example is that x minus 5 divided by x cube x square minus 6x. So its a solution, x minus 5 divided by x cube x square minus 6x. X minus 5, firstly find its a factor. So here is x, x, x. So firstly x take a common, what you will get remaining? Here x cube, x square, here x minus 6. So here x minus 5 divided by x, its root is the x plus 3 and here x minus 2. So question is that x minus 5 divided by x cube x square minus 6x. This can be written as a divided by, sorry, x minus 5, its root is the x, x minus 2, and here x minus 3. This is the first example which contain these three terms in the denominator. So this can be expressed as x minus 5 divided by x, x minus 2, and here x plus 3. So what is our main target? To separate these three terms, this term I mean multiply, to separate them. For this, so power of x is 1. So here a divided by x, b divided by x minus 2, c divided by x plus 3. So same procedure, we will multiply x, x minus 2, x minus 3, x plus 3 to this equation. Then you will get here x minus 5, so a into this x and x cancel, you will get x minus 2, here x plus 3. So b into x minus 2 cancel, x, x plus 3. C into x, x minus 2. So here three terms, that is x, x minus 2, x minus 3. First time put x is equal to 0. Second time put x minus 2 equal to 0. Third time x minus x plus 3 equal to 0. Then continuously you will get the value of a, b, c. See here, put x is equal to 0, put in this equation. Then 0 minus 5, that is 0 minus 5, here 0 minus 2 minus 2, 0 plus 3 plus 3, minus 2 into 3, that is minus 6a. Instead of x put 0, instead of x put 0. So the value of c is 0, value of b is also 0, which implies that a is 5 by 6. Next, minus minus plus, put x, second term, x minus 2 is equal to 0, which implies that x is equal to 2 in this equation. So minus plus 2 minus 5, that is minus 3. Here plus 2 minus 2, 0, means what? This a term is 0. What about b? Here 2, here 2 plus 3, 5, 5 into 2, 10b. What about this minus 2 plus 2, 0, means c is also 0. So implies that value of b is minus 3 by 10. After one term is remaining, that is x, x minus 2, remaining term is x plus 3. So put x plus 3 is equal to 0. Put x plus 3 is equal to 0, which implies x is equal to minus 3 in above expression. Then minus 3 minus 5 is the minus 8. After that, plus 3 minus 3 is the 0, a into 0. So minus 3 plus 3 is the 0, so b into 0. So we will get the value of c. C into minus 3 minus 3 minus 2. So minus 8. C into minus 3 minus 5. Minus minus plus. 3 into 5, 15. 15 c is equal to minus 8. So c is equal to minus 8 by 5. So this is the value of a, b, c. So after finding the value of a, b, c, put in this equation. The value of a is 5 by 6, value of b is minus 3 by 10, and the value of c is minus 8 by 15. So this is the particular value, and a, b, c are the arbitrary constant. So remember that these three terms are in multiply. Before this, doing partial fraction, after the using partial fraction, these three terms are the separate. Hence this is the one of the use of this partial fraction. So this is a complete rule of partial fraction, rule number first. Then there are some difficult term. How do you separate them by using partial fraction? We will see in the next lecture. Thank you.